Hey guys, it's your boy Kerberz, and welcome back to my Liverpool Chroma world. I left off, I finished off Season 1 by winning in the finals of the Europa League and the FA Cup. And this, so we are starting Season 2. First game is an away game against Watford. So it's off the Vicarage Road.
About this match today from the commentary position.
Hi there, Martin. Yeah, and expecting big things here. There's a great atmosphere.
Watford in our game today play Liverpool. Here's Watford, and this is how they're going to line up. Etienne Capoue plays with Gaston Ramirez in the engine room. We'll see how the striking option works with just one up front.
Green.
This is the Liverpool side.
Here's Bale.
Rodriguez starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Marco Reus starts.
An early foul for
doubt about that, but he's given the free kick
from the Watford
amazing
men.
Development for a player like Gareth Bale, who
apparently Bale's the player to watch. Hopefully he can take the form he started showing up at the end of last towards the back end of last season throughout this season. Just Capoue to Giroud. Bale gets it off and in.
It's just a throw after the tackle. Gaston Ramirez. Layoun. Ramirez. Etienne Capoue.
Henderson. What's up? For Correa. That first goal. Second season, Angel Correa gets the first goal of Season 2. Correa will have so much competition this season, not just with Origi, not just with Ings, but Luis Alberto is back, and I think he could, it'd be a surprise pack. It's because his last year on FIFA, he out of nowhere grew crazy. I mean, when he played against us for Borussia Dortmund
in
the Champions League, he was 88 rated at the fucking time. So, I think I got rid of Alberto too fast. Unless he asks to leave, Luis Alberto is going to get some game time. Probably mostly with the second squad, but you know, it just takes one shining performance, and you're in the first team. Origi got into the first team last season, he didn't let it go. I'm putting my faith back in Correa for the starters. Season, but we all know what happened last season. And Correa had one bad game, Origi came, and then boom, out of nowhere. Not only did Origi come back to be one probably my best player, he came top goal scorer, having played severely less league games. Here's Daniel Sturridge. Can he get the second goal? Oof. I'd better watch for a keeper. But here's Royce. It's Correa. Oh, how did that curl away from the goal? How did that happen? It curled away. It looked like it was going in and nope. It pulled a swerve on me. Motherfucker. And yes, I did call the football.
Cool.
little swear word. Why not?
My defensive record last season was very good. I want something similar this season. I'm going to aim to even concede less goals. Hell, let's aim for none at all. So that will be a task. But I have confidence in my defense and my goalkeeper. My keeper, who mind you, is the only player not who is under A rated. Because Correa is now an A rated. He went up during the summer. And our great performance in a preseason tournament helped earn him his first team place back for now. Could easily go away. No one is a sure place in this team. You know, Sturridge, Estrella Gomez. Bale can't get the ball off Jordo. Here's Lennon. Jordo again. And Varane with a great block. Come on, Coutinho. Oh, nice counter attack. Straight through from Correa. Can he double his tally? Yes, he can. And slots it home. He's going for a first game hat trick. Heck. Heck, and business as usual, boys. Continue with the fantastic through ball. Well, once it was one-on-one, there was only one winner. You bank on Argentina all the time, but because they have such good players. And all the boys came over to the ring. 2-0 is the score. Of course, I'm not done there. I want to get a third at least. Continue. Can he send another good ball? This one is for Sturridge. Sturridge will make it 3. Very easily. And we're riding the wave on to 3-0. Continue with a second assist. Beautiful control from Daniel Sturridge. And then boom, it's it first time. In off the post. Perfect.
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
New 3-0. Where they've got a winger waiting. And it's not what the Hornets were hoping for. But, you know, it has to be what they were expecting. I mean, I'm not gonna be hesitant to say I'm gonna take it easy. You know, Watford. Bale. Oh, doing some trickery. Bale. Oh, Bale. Oh, that should have been a goal. That was screaming to be a goal. And yes, you saw the big transfer during the summer. Yes, Luis Suarez went to Bayern. Yeah, that's a thing. So Bayern will be much more deadly when I come up against them in the I'm actually playing Bayern in my next game because I have them in the Super Cup. Because they they won the Champions League, so they are who I must dethrone this season. Because I'm in that competition now, and I will not be pulling any punches. I will be going in for the jugular and winning it. I'll be pulling a reverse Chelsea, winning the Europa League, then winning the Champions League. Here's Bale. 4-0. Yes, it is. Gareth. It took him a couple of games to get off the mark last season. He's off in the first game this one. Simple pass from Varane. Simple finish from Gareth Bale. And that is why he is the world record transfer in real life. Or at least until Pogba moves club, if he ever does. Kept their focus this side and taking the chances nicely when they've cropped up. I like the look about Liverpool today. Haven't been any phases. I can't see him leaving Juventus. The win that they deserve should soon be claimed. He might be happy and content to stay for his whole career. Really. Oh, Correa, the chance for the hat-trick. The block was real. Rain. Coutinho. Can't get the show. Wait, it's Royce. And Watford clear it before for the scoreline changes again. Here's Coutinho looking for Royce. Didn't find him. And oh, that's going to be a yellow card. No, never mind. It's going to be the final whistle. Oh, 4-0. Oh, picking up really where we left off at the end of last season. Winning big games. Correa showed me that, yes, indeed, he does deserve his first team place back. First game, scores a brace. And gets a 9.2. Did he get man of the match? Yes, he did. Of course he did. No one else came even close. His next highest was Varane at an 8.8. None of the Euro teams have played yet. As you can see, Millsborough have been promoted along with Sheffield Wednesday and... I think it was QPR were also promoted. So, for them, as you can see, West Brom are actually trying to sign Firmino for me. I previously told them that I'm only going to accept a certain amount, and that is 37 million, sorry, not 47. 47 would be a bit much. You know, that'd be a bit extravagant. And here's a nice scout report here. Terrible, 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 terrible. Wow, they were all terrible. Why did I go to Russia again? Something, I have to think about. I'm not sure why I went to Russia. Is this close to that, close to increasing to his E8? Really help him out with his, quest for trying to get into that first team. Same with, Luis Alberto. If he goes up to a 79, he's really close. Anyone else really close to a level up-ish? As you can see, I've also added some new players. Donza has joined the club. Nice. He's signing. Pretty happy with that. And Otazi has joined as well. Still trying to get rid of some of these younger players like Brannigan. I've got no loan offers for him. Tax year as well. Same deal. No loan offers for any of these young players. Like, this Costa kid is going to be really good. And I just hope someone will come and give him an opportunity. Emery Chan wants to discuss wages. Okay, no problem, Emery. Contracts. I hope he's not expecting to be up to a first team player. Henderson is playing out of his skin all the time, so he's not in danger of losing his spot anytime. Oh, Chan is Chan will be lucky if he gets any game time at all this season with Neves, especially with new signings like Donza. I will try and play all my players and see a healthy budget. Only 131 million and a half. With over 600k in wages. Yeah. So your standard wages, you know. That's everybody's wages, right? Oh yeah, Joe Allen, he asked for a new contract, then he rejected it. So, looking to try and move him on. And I think, that's actually the reason I signed Donza. I wasn't actually gonna sign a CM, but, like Donza, but when I realized Allen was leaving, I was like, right, I'm gonna need someone like him. And I was bringing in Utuzali here anyway, so I decided to bring in Don Surf, an old favourite from FIFA 15. Really liked him in FIFA 15. Hoping he can do some decent business in FIFA 16. Anyway, if I'm going to be honest, I'm not really too bothered about the Super Cup. I mean, you know, it is good to get a test against Bar, and especially now that they have Louis. So I'll take that as what this is. To me, he it's another friendly. They're going to get a cup if when we win. I never say if. If it's loser talk. There's the a lineup. Fuck me. That should be illegal. That lineup, that should be illegal. Seriously, that looks like something you put flowers into. Is it even made of steel? Is it made of glass? It looks like it's made of more fun glass. Who makes a trophy out of glass? That will smash. And again, Bayern do play in the Bundesliga where the title is literally a circle. Well, I still don't understand that. Really don't. Correa, boom! Straight away, three goals in two games. Don't know why I said two. I'm getting confused. Who's with goals and games? I said two goals in three games, but this is the second game. And it's 5 minutes in, and Correa has his third goal of the season already. Although, not really, this doesn't really count as a goal for the season. I mean, you know, his stats in his, in the squad report will count it, but I'm not gonna. To me, this is just a friendly. This is my way of showing myself I can compete with Nick. Though I beat Byron last season and preseason, and there's a nice goal from Marco Reus scoring against his old nemesis. This is former teammates like Lewandowski and Mario Götze, who isn't playing in the first team again. Somehow Boateng is still at Bayern Munich, and every other career mode I have done and so forth. Or as you know, I do career modes off camera, and he goes to Chelsea, so there's something for him to hold sturdy. Suarez, Lewandowski! Ah, yes, my keeper saved. Well, it wasn't the best shot Lewandowski's ever shot, but I'll take it. It's still 2-0. Penalty. It would have been a harsh penalty, wouldn't it? Sebastian, gonna put some pressure on. Rodriguez, oof. If you guys remember my goal, my team, every single one of my outfielders scored a goal in competitional play last season, so I wouldn't be surprised if, in fact, I'd actually be disappointed if they don't at least have shots every now and again, and I will. The shot was on? Why not? The shot was on. I mean, it wasn't a million miles away. Could have been worse. I could have blasted it out of the state. But no, that was relatively close. Oops. I know Suarez will be close. Here's Lam. Not exactly a goal threat, but I'm not going to let him get near the goal anyway. Or he won't have to. Suarez will do it. What the hell? Ooh. The keeper. The game had a delayed reaction there for some reason, and the keeper reacted to a button I pressed ages ago. I pressed the triangle button, which is a to try and pass it when I had the ball, but Ryan took the ball off of me, and the keeper obviously thought I was telling him to drop it when he picked it, when he got it. He was lucky enough thing happened. I mean, he's only 2 ratings higher than my backup keeper, so my backup keeper might be taking over the rings if your man doesn't go up soon. I really thought he'd grow more. He is the highest goalkeeper potential of all the keepers. There's young keepers in this game. Oh! Yes! Somehow Coutinho got that in. I think it might actually be an own goal. I think it's an own goal. Oh yeah, it's a Manuel Neuer own goal. Oh, I think he nosed it in. No, he did a seal pass.
Well, they're gonna have to show some character now, having conceded the own goal, and try and get back on level terms again. Free kick awarded against Liverpool.
Go. Ah, oh, Martz. This is preventing me from making the most of that. What should have been a counterattack. Lewandowski. Yo, Bayern are getting too close for comfort. Royce. Ah! Take the ball with you, Marco.
Well, no opposition pressure at all, and an own goal.
Ooh. No, don't put in.
Can't believe what I've just seen.
Out for a goal kick. Uh-oh. Ashton Robin. Road. Uh-oh. I don't know why, but I feel like there's a Bayern Munich goal coming. No. Here's Lahm. Yes, Laporte, you beast. In the right place at the right time. Exactly where I needed you. Aldo's his best to make sure. Work of that passing. Time. Here's Vidal again. He's back, giving it back to Louis. Vidal! Wide of the mark. He's pissed off. I'd be pissed off. Ooh, but luckily I don't have to be.
Ricardo Rodriguez.
Yes. Henderson. Continue. Yo, some. You make a run. Correa. Correa! Buries the top corner. In the 69th minute. 4-0. And Correa really hates that corner flag. I don't know why I keep doing the same celebrations. It must seem like Correa has something against the corner flags. Stupid corner flags.
Road. Suarez. Well, Ben. Martinez. Yes, my keeper. Who was alert. Lewandowski had gotten to that. That could have been disastrous. That tackle could have been disastrous. That could have been a yellow card. Actually, it probably would have been a yellow card. Connected. I was never getting the ball in that situation.
It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball.
Rain. Klein. Go, Nathaniel. Go. Run. 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 Run, Forrest. Run.
Correa for the hat trick. He's on another brace. Free kick. Are you shitting me? Continue. Taken away by Lamb. Continue loses at the Robin. Here's Vidal. Here's Lewandowski. Hey. And Nathaniel Klein says no. He'll take the booking. Come on, Robert. Get up, you dick. Is it not your cut? Oh. But the way the referee was coming over, I thought it was going to be your cut. They have Oscar as well? God damn it. Actually, that's a good thing. That week it's Chelsea. But still, god damn it. I have to compete with you guys in the... Stop strengthening in your midfield. You probably have the strongest midfield in world football. Oh, I know. Well, people will say, what about Real Madrid? Real Madrid midfield is all about one man. And it should be about the four, or like Cruz or Modric or Kovacic or Bale. But no, it's all about Ronaldo. And the players are delighted. I'm not even gonna watch. I don't even care. It doesn't count in my mind. I don't count this competition. And I don't count it as silver, same as the... The Community Shield. Well, in my eyes. Nah, after the first game, the top four is Liverpool, Manchester United, Spurs, and Villa. In this episode, I will have games against Sunderland and Norwich. Yep, Sunderland and Norwich. Norwich will be the first home game of the season. Seriously, after three away games, because technically that cup, that match against the against Bayern was away, because technically I was the away team. So yeah, fun. And West Brom have given up. Dicks. That doesn't show any determination. Nice exception from there. From Emre Can. And speaking of midfielders, looks like Joe Allen will be sold to Spurs. Can I get his valuation from you, who Spurs? Is that a possibility? I mean, 9.5, you know. I don't really need the 1 million, but if you're going to take my... a decent one on my backup midfielders, I should get something decent. I should at least get his valuation, no? But yeah, that's the... And this episode, season 2 started with a bang, and it will continue on in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. I'll see you all.